So, as we know, multiple myeloma is a plasma cell neoplasm that is characterized by progressive accumulation of clonal malignant plasma cells in the bone marrow. Recall from etiology of the multiple myeloma that malignant plasma cells are formed due to a number of various mutations that occur to a B lymphocyte, so-called B cell. The problem is that mutations in plasma cell inhibit apoptosis or stimulate cell proliferation, or both. This makes negative selection impossible and results in formation of an immortalized B cells that then become immortalized plasma cells. It can be a broken plasma cell that secretes just immunoglobulin light chains, or it can be a normal plasma cell that secretes immunoglobulin G, for example. And this time they come into the bone marrow from where they secrete immunoglobulins, which are monoclonal immunoglobulins. The specific feature of mutated plasma cells is that they cannot change the type of immunoglobulin that they produce. Moreover, they cannot modify this immunoglobulin against any other bacteria or virus. So they are perpetually doomed to produce just broken immunoglobulins with only light chain, or to produce only immunoglobulin G, for example. And because all immunoglobulins that malignant plasma cells produce just the copies of each other, such immunoglobulins called monoclonal immunoglobulins. Because mutations disrupt apoptosis, mutated plasma cells live much longer than normal plasma cells. Their proliferative rate prevails over death rate, and this results in their progressive accumulation. And because each of the mutated plasma cells secrete immunoglobulin, the higher the number of malignant plasma cells, the higher the production of immunoglobulins. Initially, a condition called monoclonal gammopathy of unknown significance develops. That is characterized by increasing amount of plasma cells in the bone marrow and increasing amount of monoclonal immunoglobulins in the blood. Then, if the second mutation occurs, this mutation will increase cell proliferation rate and will make apoptosis even less likely. So the amount of plasma cells in the bone marrow increase, and thereby simultaneously their production of monoclonal immunoglobulin will increase. And this condition called smoldering multiple myeloma. And if in addition to this, third mutation will affect the plasma cells, this mutation will make malignant plasma cells even more aggressive. So the amount of malignant plasma cells in the bone marrow will increase even further, and simultaneously their production of monoclonal immunoglobulin will increase. And now such massive plasma cell secretion will cause severe clinical symptoms that are known as CRAB criteria, and this condition called multiple myeloma. So in multiple myeloma there are a lot of mutated clonal malignant plasma cells that secrete a lot of monoclonal immunoglobulins. And to describe the full pathogenesis of multiple myeloma, let's suppose that plasma cells produce broken immunoglobulins that have only light chains. But also we know that plasma cells produce osteoclast activating factors, as Renal, that stimulates osteoclast proliferation and activity. And exactly these two products of plasma cells' activity are the key components in pathogenesis of multiple myeloma. Because there are a lot of malignant plasma cells, the production of Renal is huge. Renal is osteoclast activating factor that acts on Renal receptor on osteoclast and activates them. Because there are a lot of Renal molecules, the stimulation of osteoclast is huge. And in response to such strong stimulation, osteoclasts very rapidly begin to destroy bone tissue. The resorption of the bone tissue causes exit of calcium from the bone tissue compartment into the blood, that results in hypercalcemia. Bone destruction frequently causes bone pain, but the major problem is that with decreasing amount of calcium in the bone tissue, the density of the bone tissue decreases. So bone tissue becomes weak, and the weakening of the bone tissue greatly increases the risk of pathological fractures. Now, another substance that malignant plasma cells produce is monoclonal immunoglobulin. In our case, this immunoglobulin has only light chains. The problem is that such broken immunoglobulins cannot provide the proper immune defense that results in immune deficiency. In multiple myeloma, malignant plasma cells produce a broken monoclonal immunoglobulin that cannot fight the infection. As we know, antibodies consist of two light chains and two heavy chains. And during class switching and somatic hypermutations, some plasma cells produce broken. Such broken plasma cells can produce antibodies with only light chains, for example. And obviously, such antibodies cannot help to kill the bacteria. So, despite the presence of a huge amount of antibodies in the blood, they cannot fight the infection, and in patients with multiple myeloma, this greatly increases the risk of infection. Immunoglobulins are proteins, so increasing amount of monoclonal immunoglobulins in the blood cause increase in total blood protein level. And increase in serum protein level cause increase in erythrocyte sedimentation rate. To explain this, recall that there are a lot of red blood cells in the bloodstream, and normally they do not stick to each other. The thing that repels one red blood cell from another is negative charge on their surface. Because they have similar charges, they repel each other. But increase in amount of proteins in multiple myeloma due to the overproduction of immunoglobulins, in pregnancy for example, due to the increase in fibrinogen concentration, decrease the charges on red blood cells. Recall that mostly plasma proteins have positive charges, and this positive charge on plasma proteins can diminish or even neutralize the negative charge on the surface of red blood cells. And now, red blood cells are more prone to stick to each other, and eventually this causes formation of a stack of red blood cells that resembles a stack of coins. And in form of aggregates, red blood cells settle at much faster rate that we can observe by increasing erythrocyte sedimentation rate. Also, increasing amount of light chains in the blood can cause AL subtype of amyloidosis in various tissues throughout the body. The concept is that light chains allow molecular structures, and because they are smaller than complete immunoglobulin, they can easily enter into the tissues where they progressively accumulate. Progressive accumulation of light chains in the tissues cause amyloidosis. Also, light chains enter into the kidneys, and exactly this feature makes light chains a particular dangerous for the kidneys. The problem here is that light chains are extremely toxic for epithelium in renal tubules, and this causes severe damage to the kidney that results in renal insufficiency, so-called myeloma kidney. And after they cross renal tubules, light chains are excreted from the organism through the urine. So light chains can be excreted from the organism through the urine, and increasing amount of monoclonal immunoglobulins in the urine cause proteinuria. Another problem is that the higher the blood calcium level, the higher will be the calcium excretion through the urine. And in kidney tubules, positively charged calcium can react with negatively charged phosphate group or with oxalate that results in formation of a kidney stones. So high blood calcium level causes increased in formation of kidney stones that can aggravate renal injury, thereby contributing to renal insufficiency. And renal insufficiency manifests with elevation of blood creatinine and urea level. With severe damage to the kidney, the production of erythropoietin by the kidneys decrease. Thereby, the level of red blood cells and hemoglobin will decrease. And the condition that is characterized by low level of hemoglobin called anemia. So multiple myeloma leads to severe damage to the bone tissue that subsequently causes hypercalcemia. Hypercalcemia, together with extremely high production of monoclonal pathological immunoglobulin, leads to renal insufficiency that is characterized by high creatinine level. Renal damage causes decreasing erythropoietin production that leads to anemia. Together, these manifestations known as CRAB criteria. In addition to CRAB symptoms, in multiple myeloma, excessive production of monoclonal immunoglobulin leads to immune deficiency and to elevation in total protein level. And production of light chains also lead to amyloidosis. If you like content, please press like and subscribe button. All the best!